to Music Reading 7. In this lesson of music reading, we're going to move up quite high on the neck into the 11th and 12th positions. Up in this higher register, we're going to study a collection of four reading pieces that will involve reading music up in these higher register frets. And this area of the neck is going to cover from as low as the guitar's 11th fret up to as high as the 16th fret. And for our melodies in Lesson 7, they'll involve notes from as low as the 11th fret of the 6th string E flat up to as high as the pitch at the 15th fret of the first guitar string, that's a high G up there. So up in this higher register fretboard region, we're going to study a collection of sharp and flat keys, including the keys of C major, G major, B flat major, and F major. So let's get started by making a study of our first reading piece within the 12th position using notes from the key of C major. All right, in exercise number one, we're locked up here in the 12th position reading area, and we're doing the key of C major. Now, with the key of C major in this region, it's actually usually a very easy region for people to get to know because it's a total duplicate of what happens down here in the open position off of all the open strings. Just, you know, in this area, the open strings now become all the 12th fret notes, and the rest of the positions layout, you know, it's all exactly the same. You know, you got E, F, G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A. It's the exact same thing as, you know, the layout that we have from open position, you know. So if you know open position, 12th position usually comes very quickly. The thing that's going to be tough is dealing with all ledger lines, because we've got a lot of ledger line usage that we have to take into consideration here. So let's just go over the notes that we have in this region. We'll get them broken down over to the music staff so you understand everything that's happening. We're going to go from the lowest 6th string 12th fret E here to get started with. On the music staff, that's the first line of the staff, so it's similar to the E that we would have played at the 7th fret or the E that we would have here at the 2nd fret of 4th string. It's the exact same E. It's a unison note, in other words. Now, from that tone, what we're going to be doing is rolling across, going E, F, G, and we just match that from the first line of the staff over to this first space of the staff, second line of the staff for the G. When we move to the 5th string, we're going to have the second space of the staff, third line of the staff, third space of the staff for C, and then the D and E and F tones move us into the 4th line of the staff, 4th space, and then the 5th line, and that's where we start moving beyond the staff, up above it, starting to tackle some of the ledger line ideas. Starting with G, we have first space above the staff, but the A is the first ledger line. After that, we have our high B, and that's the first, second space above the first ledger line, and after that we move into the C, the octave, which is on the second ledger line above the staff. Above that is going to be D, and then we'll move to the first string where on the third ledger line above the staff we'll have E. The F is above that third ledger line, and then the G is sitting on the fourth ledger line above the staff. So we're really high with ledger lines, and that's why later we're going to be introducing a concept called reading 8VA, reading up an octave higher, and that's going to really help us to get away from having to look at so many ledger lines in a piece of music. It can get very confusing when you have a lot of them that you have to stare at, and it's when things are confusing on any level, you know, mistakes creep in, so we don't want that. So we're going to try and make things easier down the road when I introduce reading an octave higher to you. But now that we've covered the music staff, over to what's the, you know, layout with our key of C major. And by the way, if you're following my intermediate or my advanced guitar program, you're probably also seeing this as well as a pattern number one C major scale in this region, the way it's laid out from fifth string to second string. Now, let's start getting into what's happening with the melody that we have here. It's a nice melody. It's all really kind of higher notes, starting on that high C at the second line above the staff there. It's a dotted quarter note as well, so you got to hold it for a wee bit. One and two and three and four and. After that dotted quarter note, it's all eighth notes after that, so it's pretty straightforward in terms of timing, but you have to hold that first note a little bit. We're also going to be in that measure getting an A and a G and then an E back to the G again. So lot of third string, fourth string notes going on there. Then we're going to go back to that C, and at that point we're going to go above here, get a high F, E, D, C, E. So we're dealing with all the high ledger lines now in that little phrase. The D comes back around, and then we do a scale run from G, A, B, C, D, you know, covering from the upbeat of two there. So if we counted that third measure, it would be one and two and three and four and one, two, three, four. You can tell the C and the G wrap things up on the final measure, just as half notes. So it's kind of simple resolution there at the end. But when we get to the next line, we're going to be going a little bit more into a new sort of phase of ideas here. And in this area, we're going to be using a section repeat for two measures that show up in the beginning of the second line. We're going to be coming off of an A to get things started, and then heading into a C tone, and then a G into that C tone. Then what we're going to do is have a high D there, 15th fret, second string D, up to the E, back to the D, then the C will resolve things. And we're going to do that two times. Right, then for wrapping things up, we're going to have a different phrase that's kind of in the middle string sets here, starting from an E, so that's at the 4th string, 14th fret. We're going to head to a G, then an F tone will come in, drop us back to the E. Then after that, what we're going to do is grab the D note on the 4th string, 12th fret, jump over across a perfect 5th to an A, and then we're going to have a B note up to a D note, and that'll take us over to our resolution for our key center on the key center tone of C. And then we'll have a little two-note major third chord idea there, a little double stop or a dyad, whatever you want to call it there, and that wraps the piece up. So watch those notes just before we do the wrap-up measure, because it's kind of a unique passage of tones. You got the E, G, F, E, D, A, B, D, C. It's a little bit unique there at the end. So anyway, that wraps up exercise number one, 12th position layout for the key of C. We're just going to wrap up part one of the lesson plan here, and then we'll come back next with the key of G major in the second part of the video. Don't forget that there's still two more segments after that, because we still are also going to do B flat major and F major in this position as well. By the time we're wrapped up lesson seven here, you're really going to have a good handle on what's happening up here in the 12th position. That was an excerpt from the seventh lesson in my music reading course. The remainder of this lesson is available behind a paywall on my website at creativeguitarstudio.com. But I thought you might like to see this segment here, so I put it on YouTube for you to get a better idea about what this music reading course actually has to offer. If you want to subscribe to my website and gain access to this course along with my introductory, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs, plus many other elective guitar courses on the website, just head on over to creativeguitarstudio.com, sign up with a free membership to get started, and then after that you can always upgrade to either a monthly, or you could go with the discounted yearly membership plan. Just click on the link in the YouTube description box under where it says become a member today. If you want to learn the modes and get a really good understanding for how they can be used musically to write songs, play a solo, or compose melody lines, then you're in luck. My ebook, Using the Major Scale Modes, is a comprehensive manuscript outlining exactly how modes are used in respect to harmony and to compose or improvise melodic ideas. Over 50 pages of scale patterns, example progressions, and music theory all come together to create a comprehensive method on how to use the modes that's easy to understand. Using the Major Scale Modes is available for instant download in the View Our Products area at creativeguitarstudio.com. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com for the rest of this reading lesson. We'll carry on with further study in the 11th and 12th position keys of G major, B flat, as well as the key of F. Also, if you have a paid membership, you'll get access to this lesson's handout, all of the MP3 play-along tracks, plus a whole lot more.